Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen wa salatu wa salamu ala al-mab'uthi rahmatan lil alameen. Subhanaka la ilma lana illa ma 'allamtana innaka antal 'alimul hakim. Dear brothers and sisters, in this month of Ramadan, I would like to share with you this short reminder about a topic which should be in the start of this month, and that is at-Tawbah, repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To have a good start in the month of Ramadan and to make the most of it, we have to start on a good ground. And that ground is by performing Tawbah. Tawbah means going back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by abandoning all kinds of disobedience, regretting having doing it in the past, in the moment, and also have the determination, the resolve not to do it again. These three components, regret, seeking forgiveness from what you did, and having the resolution not to go for it again, is three preconditions to accept Tawbah by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And of course, when it comes to the rights of people, you have to return the rights to them or ask their forgiveness. Or if you can't, then make dua for them and try to make good deeds. Because in the day of judgment, there is no currency. There is no commodities. There is good deeds and bad deeds. That's the currency on the day of judgment. Now, some people will say, why should we repent? We don't commit major sins. We are good people. We are obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let's remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered all the believers to have Tawbah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah An-Nur, verse 31, وَتُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا أَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. And turn to Allah in repentance, all of you, O believers, that you might succeed. And might succeed in the Quran, when it comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, means for sure you will succeed if you repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So to get success, you need to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Some people might think that repentance only when it comes to committing sins by like doing things that we should do. But repentance also must be from things that we should do but we don't do. التوبة من ترك الواجبات. As an example, if you don't pray Fajr on time, that's before sunrise, then you are committing a sin. And that's a sin that you need to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who is the optimal example of good servant to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the companions told us that they were counting for him, repeating Astaghfirullah wa atubu ilayh, like making repentance and seeking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more than 70 times in one sitting. In one sitting, he might exceed 70 or 100 times making repentance. Although we all know that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah has forgiven his past and future sins. And that is when Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her, asked him about his making qiyam. He made qiyam until his feet swollen, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So she said, why do you do all that while Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forgiven your past and future sins? He said, shouldn't I be a grateful servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that's ibadah, is a way of saying thank you, O Allah. We are grateful for all the pleasures that you bestowed, all the favors that you bestowed on us. Health, safety, and iman, family, good Muslim community, alhamdulillah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us more out of His bounty. So the Prophet ﷺ used to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. More than 70 times, he is saying, Astaghfirullah wa atubu ilayh. What about me and you? Also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, in Surah Al-Hujurat, verse 11, وَمَنْ لَمْ يَتُبْ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الظَّالِمُونَ. And whoever does not repent, he is the aggressors. He is the ظالم, the unjust. The unjust. Ibn al-Qayyim, may Allah have mercy on his soul, said, look how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala divided people into two categories. Either repenters or unjust and wrongdoers. So وَمَنْ لَمْ يَتُبْ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الظَّالِمُونَ. It's either تائبون أو ظالمون. So we better for us to choose to be for those who repent, because Allah loves the repenters. If you repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will be one of those who Allah loves. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ التَّوَّابِينَ, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran. So tawbah has to be sincere. It is, sincerity here means I do it because I want to please Allah alone. I didn't do it for convenience. I didn't do it because I can't commit the sin anymore, so let me now repent. But have the intention, if I have the opportunity to commit the sin again, I will do it. That's not a repentance. You cannot cheat Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ يَعْلَمُ مَا فِي أَنفُسِكُمْ. Allah knows what's in our hearts. So we have to be careful and be sincere and honest in our repentance. And having that determination not to commit the sin ever again, to the best of our ability. We might go back and commit it, then we should have the resolve to repent again. Don't let the shaitan push you in the trap of losing hope of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah will accept you no matter what, as long as you repent sincerely before the moment of death, or before the sun will rise from the west, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us. So don't despair and lose hope. Allah will accept your repentance no matter what. Allah accept even the repentance of the kafir. When they abandon kufr and choose Islam, Allah accept them. So how would you think that Allah will not accept your repentance? Even if you do the sins 1,000 times and you repent for the 1,000th time, Allah will accept you again, provided that you really regret and have remorse and you are really have the resolve not to go back and you ask for forgiveness. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give it to you, will grant you forgiveness. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-Ghafoor, ar-Rahman, ar-Rahim, at-Tawwab. Think of these beautiful names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you will know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as He accepted that person, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us about from Bani Israel, a person who killed 100 people and then he repented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah accepted his repentance and he bestowed his mercy on him. As'alullah azza wa jal أن يغفر لي ولكم وأن يتوب علي وعليكم وأن يجعلنا من التوابين المتطهرين. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم، ونلتقي إن شاء الله في موعظة أخرى قريبا إن شاء الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Thanks for watching our video. If you liked what you saw, please consider supporting our masjid so we can continue to bring you quality Islamic videos. Producing these videos takes effort, and your donation will make a big difference in helping us reach thousands of people around the world. Also, please don't forget to like and subscribe and click the bell icon so you'll be notified of our future videos. Please visit our website, mymasjid.ca/donate, for more information. May Allah reward you for your support.